SEA Games gold medalist and Olympic hopeful Filipino-Japanese Juna Chokii is on her way to achieving her dreams of making it to the Olympics. Juna recently won her tournaments in Serbia and Portugal, boosting her chances for a spot in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. ANC catches up with Juna in this exclusive interview. Juna Chokii, thank you so much for joining us here on ANC Conversations. It is an honor. It's really a great to have you here, SEA Games gold medalist, also from karate. Juna, you had your recent tournament in Serbia. Can you tell us more about that and your preparations for that tournament?
Yes, I trained 2 months in Serbia with top players from the world. For example, who are world champions and who are Europe champion, Pan American champion. They are very strong. So I'm so happy training with them.
How was it? How was the whole tournament? If I'm not, can you correct me if I'm wrong? Was this your first tournament ever since COVID happened?
No, it's actually it's second tournament.
Second tournament.
Before I have in, I think March in Turkey is our first tournament. But for the Olympic qualifying is the first after okay. COVID.
All right. So how was it like? How was it like, you know, long layoff, long time, no usual training and no tournaments? All right, Juna, how was it like for you coming in to this first Olympic qualifier?
Yes, even this hard situation, I know everyone keep training, hard work. So, and my opponents are all is strong. I respect them, but also, I do hard work a lot in here. Every day, my body is very pain, tired. My muscle is pain. Sometimes I can walk up from the tire, but still, even that, I try to my best every day for this tournament. So, I fight with myself. It's not about other. It's myself. Even you're tired? No, I push myself. No, you do more and more, you can do more like that.
How challenging is that? Can you tell us more about that? You are in competition with yourself. Can you tell us more about that?
Yes. First, we training, of course, physical training and stamina training and technical training. But in the last 3, we also training in our weakness. So my weakness is like this. So, of course, it's my weakness. So it's very hard to get is better because, for example, I'm not good for like a hubble for my opponent. I good for counter, but I'm not good for like always hubble like attack right. Attacks. But I train for that, like 100,000 or more for this because I'm not good for this. So first I accept my weakness and second step, I try to be fix it.
Maybe in boxing analogy, I just relate that to boxing, you are a counter puncher, more of
the
aggressor,
yes, that's
right?
True.
But of course, now translating it to karate. Juna also,
yes.
maybe it's the first time that our ANC viewers that will, you know, get to see you through a virtual call or an interview. Can you tell us more what it's life like as an Olympic hopeful, right? Especially during these times.
Now I know everyone stay in hard situation. So first, I hope all people stay safe and health. And second, yes, if they have Olympics, I give my all for this. So if I can, if we have Olympics and I can play there, of course, my goal is not just play, aim for gold medal.
Mm-hmm. All right, so when you talk about gold medal, can you tell us more about your experience in the 2019 SEA Games, and you also won a gold medal there. So can you tell us more about that experience, Juna?
Yes, if my first SEA Games, it was 2017, and I lost in semifinals, and I just got bronze. So after that, I'm so frustrated, so why I cannot get gold, what's my mistake, why I'm so weak, like I attack myself a lot of time, but I promise with me next SEA Games in Philippines, I'm sure I get gold. I give everything for that. So I training all the world to who are a good player or who are strong player than me. I always challenge them strong person, not like a similar or not a situation, not right. easy situation. I choose hard situation because it make me strong. Right. So that's why in the SEA Games in that time, so I can be relaxed because I do everything before the matches.
Can you tell us more about your Olympic dreams? When did it start? When did this start? And how important is this for you to achieve this?
Yes, it's actually for karate, it's the first time to join the Olympics. Before, we don't have karate event in Olympics. And I heard this news 2015 or 16 is karate be the Olympics. And that time I was stay in Japan and I was national team in Japan. But I have friend in Philippines who play karate in Philippines, and I heard that situation. So maybe if I can get some success for Olympics or for road of this, maybe I can help something for my friend, for my Philippines country also. So that's why I choose for Philippines for fight Olympics, because I want do something. I don't know what I do because that time I'm not champion. I'm not strong player, but I just want to do health, and it's my passion.
So Juna, just to clarify, what I hear you saying is, if you are going to go to the Olympics, you want to represent the Philippines.
Yes,
right.
Yes, I want to represent the Philippines and win gold medals. And if I get this one, maybe I can something to do for for my country. I don't know what but maybe.
Well, just you giving your all and giving it enough, that's doing the best for the country. And Filipinos really do appreciate that. Juna, we wish you success, of course, in the in your upcoming bid to be qualified in the Tokyo Olympics. Also, Juna, can you tell us more about the relationship of you and your father? That father and daughter, but coach and athlete relationship.
Yes.
How is that like?
Yes, when I was young, he always he's very strict about training, but not about only training, about how you stay your life. Like if you have power, you are strong, you must protect other person. He always teach me about that. If a strong person is not use power for yourself, if this is used for other person. So I follow what he teach me, and now, yes, we cannot talk more open because I'm afraid to my dad. He's very very strict. Mm-hmm. But now when I grow now and we are stay different, my father stay Japan and I'm stay other country always. So when meet in the competition, we can more open to talk about my feeling and about my games. So now we have good connection and we have trust, and he knows everything of me and I know everything of him. So it's very good for me when I fight.
Now Filipinos may be familiar with our Kappa Filipinos also staying in US or in Europe or in Japan, but it's not so common in Serbia, right? Not so common for people we know who are now based in Serbia. So what is life like? I know there's a 6-hour difference. That's all I know. What's life like for you, Juna?
Yes, and why I choose here, first, they have our own gym and everything, like a physical gym and karate gym. So very close. So even this situation, you can go to easy. No need ride the taxi, no need ride train, just by walk. And second, in here, who are world champions from Serbia, she has small team, is not big team, but she a champion. So before I'm asking for her, why? How you be a champion like that? And She's story very inspired me. So I asked for them to, can I join with you because I won't follow your training program or everything. So they say, yes, welcome. We are always welcome of you. And they invite me. So now I can train here.
So Serbia is the way to go for you to be able to achieve what you want when it comes to training and results.
Yes, even Serbia's coach is not my original coach because they have player and she are a coach of Serbia. But mm-hmm. even different country, she treat me like a family. She treat me my training. She think my training program. She think about my game. So she care about like a family for me.
All right. So Juna, what is next for you? How will you be able to qualify for the Tokyo Olympics?
Yes, we have tournament again in next month, qualifying in Paris. So I need to get medals in there. So if I can get medal, I'm sure I go to Olympics. And now I have good result, best result from this tournament. So I'm sure I can do it.
All right. So what kind of medals? Is there like a minimum requirement
minimum
for you?
Bronze.
Bronze medal in the next tournament, and you will qualify for the Tokyo Olympics. So the Filipinos are rooting for you with that. Lastly, Juna, your message to the Filipino fans, sports fans.
Thank you for your support and chilling. So always I watching my Facebook. There are many people say like proud of you. Thank you for representing the Philippines. Thank you for your choose Philippines like that. So I love the kind of message. That's because in Japan, they're shy. They even they think they not say like that. But in Philippines, they say they hug me. So I'm very appreciate that. So always maraming salamat po. So I will do my best for para sa bayan.
All right, maraming salamat, Juna Chokhi, for guesting here and talking to us here on ANT Conversations. Good luck, and Filipinos are always going to be rooting for you, Juna. Thank you so much.